Tonight we heard from a president who has spent the past year putting America first, making American families better off than they were just 1 year ago. We are building a safe and strong nation that puts the dreams of American families, farmers, and the American worker above all else. Supporting our men and women in uniform, growing our economy and creating jobs, rolling back unnecessary regulations, securing our borders, and negotiating fair agreements. That is just some of what our president has delivered on his first year in office. And as a result, 1.7 million new jobs have been created. Our economy is growing and unemployment claims have fallen to 4.1%, their lowest level in almost 20 years. At this same point in the Obama presidency, we had lost 4 million jobs. Our economy was shrinking and unemployment was quickly approaching 10%. So are you better off than you were 1 year ago? We have put an end to the bad deals America was getting from rogue nations like Iran and North Korea. Our military is stronger than ever before. ISIS is all but decimated, and it has been made clear that America stands united with its allies like Israel. With President Trump at the helm, we have eliminated more than $4 billion in unnecessary and overly burdensome regulations. The kind of regulations holding back small businesses and farmers from investing, growing, and hiring here in America. We've been able to put your money back in your pocket with the success of the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act. Just last week, I visited businesses in Dent and Texas counties who were handing out bonuses, increasing wages, or strengthening their employee benefits as a direct result of the tax cuts bill passed in December. It is amazing the difference a change in administrations makes. Tonight, we did not hear talk of punishing American businesses, American workers, and American farmers. Instead, tonight, we heard a call to continue to put all of them first, whether that be investing in new infrastructure or continuing to do everything required to keep American families safe. As we saw from the guest in attendance, there is more work to be done. Millions of Americans are dying from the crushing opioid crisis, and gangs like MS-13 and others continue to wreak havoc across our cities and small towns. There were many opportunities tonight for my colleagues on both sides of the aisle to stand and join with our president in these efforts. I hope they will realize that the agenda this president puts above all else, America first, isn't Republican and isn't Democrat. I'm honored to be your voice in Congress. I look forward to another year of serving you and working with our president to put you and your loved ones first by keeping our country safe, strong, and prosperous.